Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making clove-studded red cinnamon pears. And this is a condiment for your Christmas table, if you'd like to do that, or any holiday table. It goes really well with ham. It goes well with turkey. So those are the two major meats that most of us use. But then you could have chicken or just about anything. If you like the flavor of pears and you like the Red Hot Cinnamon Candy flavor with it. So let me show you how to make it. And I'm just making enough for my family, which is going to look small for a large crowd. So you may have to multiply the recipe by two or three and make larger containers for making it and storing it. This is a 29-ounce can of pears. These happen to be light pear halves, and they're in pear juice from concentrate. So they're not in heavy syrup where a lot of sugar is added, and they're not packed in water, which would make them kind of watery. So that's a good choice that you might make. And when you get them, you'll drain them, and the syrup, or the juice, I should say, from the pears is right here. And you want to hang on to that because you're going to use it. And the pear halves themselves we have right here. And you can see how large they are. In fact, I'm going to cut those in half. I have one here that isn't very large. It's a pear half, but it's not a large one. I'll still cut it in half. So the first step would be to take each one of these and just take a paring knife and come down, try to evenly cut that into two parts. So really we're having pear quarters. This will not work very well with sliced pears. So get the pear halves and then get them into quarters. If you find pear quarters somewhere, that would be fine, but you can make them yourself very easily and very quickly. So it's just a few minutes and we'll have these all sectioned out, and then I'll show you the next step. This is that last one that's not too big. The next step is to take one of these quarters, and then I have some cloves lying here, and you're going to put some cloves in. This is a clove-studded condiment, and you can make designs if you want to. You can get really creative with this. I'm just going to make a single strip down the back, kind of like I did the orange pomander the other day. And it's up to you as to how many you put in. It doesn't really require a lot. It's partly for looks and partly for flavor. So just do it to your liking and then put it back in the bowl with the others and continue until you have all of them looking like that. Or you can make a diamond shape, just something that's interesting and appealing to your guests. So let me get these done and then I'll come right back and work on our syrup. You can see how the pear halves or pear quarters look once they have the cloves in them. And I just made the same design on every one of them. And I plan to serve them in the bowl, this bowl, or perhaps a similar bowl, because it's nice and clear and will look really good when these turn red. And they will turn red from the red cinnamon candies that we're going to use. But in order for that to happen, we're going to have to make a sauce, and we're going to have to pour it over the pears. It won't work really well to have the pears in this bowl and pour that sauce over it, because it will not cover the pears completely. So what I plan to do is to put these in a jar, just kind of tightly in there, so that they're very compact, and we'll be able to put the syrup that we make up as far as it will reach. And then we can come by and shake it every once in a while, because it's going to be stored in the refrigerator. You really need to start this particular dish at least a day ahead of time, if not longer than that. This will keep in the refrigerator very well for 1 week. So it looks like we're canning something, but actually we're just kind of pickling it in red candy cinnamon flavor. and we want the color to change and its character to change. So the next thing is I've got a little juice that came off of that. So we'll put our juice together. My hands are a little sticky, so I'm just gonna rub them off here. And I'll show you what else goes into our juice. Take all of the reserved pear juice, and there may be some pieces of pear in it. If that bothers you, you can remove those, you can just strain it. But the nature of this is that it's made up of pears anyway, so it doesn't hurt for this juice that's going to be put over the top of it eventually. It doesn't hurt for it to have pieces of pear in it. So we're going to put 1 cup of sugar. So it's just regular white granulated sugar. And then we're going to put our red hot cinnamon candies. This is a package that's not been opened, and they're called Cinnamon Imperials. But you've probably all had those. 1/4 cup, I made mine a little bit heaping because I want that nice red color and the good cinnamon flavor. Now I will tell you ahead of time, we're going to cook this on the stove. We're going to let it boil for about 15 minutes and I'll be stirring every once in a while. And then we'll bring it off and put it over our pears, seal them up, and then we'll let them cool. Well, we'll let them cool a little bit, seal them up, put them in the refrigerator. But I have sitting here some red food coloring, because if the color isn't nice and deep and attractive, then we want to deepen that artificially. So we'll check and see what we have after we have boiled our red cinnamon candies along with the pear juice and sugar. So this goes to the stove over, we'll turn it on medium heat, and then we may reduce the heat a little bit, and we'll let it cook for about 15 minutes, and then it will be to the point where we're ready to consider putting it on the pears. Here is my pear syrup that has the cinnamon candies and sugar melted in it. And you can see it's red. Actually, I put it in this pot that has a black nonstick surface here, and you can't tell too much about the color. So what I want to do is pour it out in this bowl, just so you could have an idea of what it's going to look like. It's not going to stay there, but if I did nothing to it, it is a pretty color. But what we want to do is to have that color to be infused into these pear quarters that have been studded with cloves. So I think it would be nice to have a little more red. So I'm going to add some artificial color. You don't need to do this. If you're against artificial color, then don't bother. But I think it's just going to make it look a little more appealing, and it's very little that you would need to add to perk up that color a bit. It just makes it look more cinnamony, more flavorful, even though it does not change the flavor at all. So I think it's going to be kind of hard for me to pour from the bowl into my jar, so I'm going to put it back in my pot, which has some lips there for pouring. And then what we want to do is to pour this over our pears. I'm going to put this in the sink quickly. So here we go. Over the pears, just pour gently. Isn't that pretty? The look that it gives. And actually you can see this amount of syrup would have done probably twice as many pears. So I'm going to fill it up to the top, and that causes some of my pear quarters to float, but that's all right. And then you really need it tightly sealed. So if you are putting it in a jar like this, you need a screw top lid or improvise in some way so that you can get a nice seal. Now this is the last you're going to see of this on this video, because this is going to be stored in my refrigerator until I get ready to serve it on my Christmas dinner. So these are our clove-studded red cinnamon candy pears. I hope you enjoy them.